Hey friends, David here from Learn Stage Lighting. Got my coffee here, it's a new day. Let's talk about our next tip for working in larger venues. So in our last video, we talked about how to fill the space with pattern and really with color of light in different ways that you can change it up. So if you missed that video, check that out here. Now in today's video, I want to talk to you about how in the world to keep different sight lines in mind. Picture this. If you come from a typical background and you're used to working in maybe small or mid-sized venues, a lot of times you're in what I would call a very typical room where you might have some front light on the stage. You know, hopefully you've got lights at your 245s off center. That's a really good angle to work with. If you're interested for more information on that, check out this video on creating an awesome even wash of stage light. So you've got that going. And for a lot of rooms, a lot of small to mid-sized venues, the typical audience member is going to generally be in front of that stage, okay? But when we make it into the larger venues, there can be a couple different situations that come up and we gotta figure out how the heck to deal with them, right? So one situation is the large church, right? And in a lot of large churches, it can be very popular to go ahead and do a very wide fan-shaped room. You may have seen this before, where you've got a stage on one side of the room, and the front of it is actually like octagon-shaped, like a half octagon or a half hexagon, right? Where it's got different stair sides. And then sometimes you just have people on the front side of that, but sometimes these stages are very wide to the point where you actually have people that are sitting and they're actually looking at the side of the person on stage. They're literally 90 degrees from that person, okay? This happens more often in large venues than other sizes. The other thing that you might see is that if you're in an arena or some sort of a multi-purpose venue where you've taken a big open space, plopped down a stage in it, and then seats get sold or you know, ticketed, and people are sitting literally beside the stage, sometimes even behind the stage, okay? And while the people, you would think, right, well, hopefully they would have enough sense, and not everybody thinks about lighting, so I'm not calling them stupid, I'm just saying that they're not thinking about lighting like we are, right? While most people, if they're literally on the side of a stage, literally looking sideways at that stage, you would think that they would go, oh, okay, the lighting, the visual aspect of the show might be subpar, okay? However, there's some dynamics that change this game, right? It used to be that if you were getting seats that were beside or behind a stage in an arena, that they were like way cheaper than the other tickets, but they're not always anymore. Sometimes they're almost as expensive as other tickets because you're fairly close, but you're just at a really funky angle. And so what we need to do is we get into a larger venue, and also with larger venues tends to come more cameras, okay? And these cameras can be at these same angles, right? Where a camera can be at the side of stage shooting at a performer. They can be, you know, somebody, a walking camera person can be back by the drummer and they're shooting backwards, you know, into the guitarist from behind, etc. When you've got this happening, when you've got different sight lines from side, from up high, from down low, from behind, okay? You want to keep those different sight lines in mind when designing and programming your lighting for this larger venue. So what are some practical ways to make this work? Okay, the first thing you've got to remember, number one, is that the front sight line where most of the audience is still the most important. Okay, so with anything you're doing, and the good thing is you're usually controlling or programming lights from this front angle, that's the most important, right? If most people are there, that's gonna be the most important angle. But if we're in a space, and as I linked to my video before on creating an awesome even wash of stage light, I often talk about using three-point lighting. It's a very typical approach to lighting, where you've got two front lights at 45 degrees, one backlight. Well, what this does is, for people at a front angle, or where cameras are at a very frontal angle, right, anywhere that the audience may be, maybe straight on, maybe at a 45, maybe close to the front of the stage and somewhat sideways, this lighting tends to look pretty good, okay? But I'm going to make a tweak here on this, okay? Because if you've got people 360 degrees around a performer, then that space between the front 45s and the back that's maybe 60 degrees up and straight back, that space between the two, those kind of blind spots per se, are not that well lit, okay? If a person or a camera is, you know, anywhere mostly on the front, you know, 180 degrees, it's going to look good. But if they get in the back, you hit dark spots, you hit blind spots. And so this is where there's a slightly different approach to lighting called four-point lighting that can really help in a larger venue like this. It's just, boom, 45s from the front, 45s from the back, okay? So that every quarter, every, you know, 90 degrees, basically, there is a fresh light the whole way around the object or person that you're lighting, okay? This is one way to get around this. You still, when you set up and set the brightness of the lights, generally have the front lights brighter, the back a little dimmer, or in color, and you still get that shaping, but you eliminate dark spots around this person with four-point lighting as well. Just to harp on this a little, this isn't a complete tutorial to it, but you generally take one of your front lights and make it the key light. This comes from a video or photographic lighting. That one tends to be brighter than the other three, okay? But as always, you know, do what feels right. Start with some of the guidelines that I put in here, but ultimately look at your cameras, see how they look, look with your eye, see how it looks. If it looks weird or odd, change it, right? If it looks like there's a really big dark spot on one side of the person, bring that light up or bring the other light down to get them to be a little closer together, okay? If you want to stick with a pretty standard three-point lighting, you still can go ahead and cover that area really well by using some side lights. You may see this a lot at various shows where there's a side truss with lights on it that provides side light. Again, if this is, you know, a musical act or theater or basically anything that's not like a spoken word presenter, like a pastor or a motivational speaker, then any side lights or backlight, they don't have to be in white. We just need to get some light on the people so that if somebody's at this angle, especially if there's a camera at this angle, and even if it's not a camera you're using on screens in your show, there's a camera that the audience member's pointing, right? They're grabbing their phone, they're taking that video, okay? It's great for them to see color or texture from a gobo. It's not great if it's a dark spot because that looks bad, right? Okay? And so the biggest key here, as I wrap this video up for you guys, is you want to go ahead when you're designing a show for a larger venue. And more than other size venues, you need to think about different sight lines that you're going to come into and figure out the best ways to get lighting. This doesn't have to be rocket science. In fact, if you just go set up a typical three-point lighting, and maybe it's a large church, and over time you see that we've got some people or cameras on the extreme left or extreme right, and all we want to do with those is just bring in a little side light. It doesn't even have to be that bright to fill that in. You can add that over time, right? But the biggest thing is just thinking about, okay, what are the different places where we have people and or cameras, and how do we light, making sure that we don't completely ignore those folks, those cameras, and their point of view? And when you do that, you get lighting in a larger venue that looks super professional, that looks great from any angle, and elevates you as a lighting person, even if it's the first time you've lit for a larger venue. If you've enjoyed these tips, be sure to grab our full playlist here. And if you're brand new to lighting, you're just getting started out with this stuff, grab my free guide to begin with lighting. It's custom tailored to the type of lighting you do, band, church, DJ, and or theater. Okay, grab those over at learnstagelighting.com. You can click here for that. And also check out this video. This is the first video here in this series. I want you to check it out if you haven't already. It talks all about the unique challenges with large venues and how we can overcome them. And then you'll check out the rest of the playlist from there. Thanks so much and have a great day.